Hello, it's your boy Davidoff. Remember to request me which round 10 games you want to react to. I'll react to like 3 or 4 of them if I see 3 or 4. And from round 11 onwards, I'll be reacting to every single game from each round. So yeah, things are changing because you guys want more games, so I will give you more games. I'll react to every single game from round 11 onwards. But for round 10, just a few games because I'm busy this weekend. So yeah, I'm recording this on like Tuesday as well. Anyway, let's go. Road to Victory 2016 Grand Financial Feature. After this, we got AFL Big Bumps and Boomer 427. So let's go straight into it. This one's the longest, 8 minutes long. Let's just sit back and watch this. To be fair, I'm not sitting back, but still.
The Western Bulldogs started season 2016 with a strong statement.
Here is Bontempelli now.
Nice. He's a brilliant player. Brilliant player.
The Slick Dogs made the day's Dockers look like they were running in wet sand as they set up a 10-goal win.
Nice. That was a brilliant goal.
His first game since 2014, Tom Liberatore celebrated with 25 possessions.
Torre goes for goal.
Nice.
And he gets it.
In round two, the Bulldogs didn't hit the height of their dazzling round one performance, but were never seriously challenged by the Saints.
Maintained possession and then we saw it on the wrong way to the man, and then he kicks a brilliant goal.
In round three, the Western Bulldogs were to face their first big test of 2016. In what was dubbed a clash between the challengers and the champions, Hawthorn showed why it's been the competition's benchmark for the past three seasons with a brilliant comeback win.
Ah, on top of
the 3-point loss, Bulldogs captain Robert Murphy injured his knee.
Oh, no.
For the rest of 2016, the much-loved Bulldog would have to watch his team from the sidelines.
Unlucky.
The Bulldogs bounced back the next week, but more injuries suffered against the Blues made the round four.
Yeah, injuries are the worst in sport.
The string with a monster kick.
Unfortunately, it's part of the game, but it's so annoying when it happens.
The Bulldogs beat Brisbane by 53 points, but again, victory came at cost. Ooh. Recruit Matt Suckling tweaked the medial ligament in his reconstructed right knee injured a rolled ankle.
They had a rough start. They had a really rough start.
North Melbourne in round six, but not without a fight. In a return to their early season form, the Bulldogs kicked their highest score of the season against Adelaide to give the biggest indication yet they can overcome their injuries and match it with the best. Holding on in a desperate finish to win by 15 points.
Nice.
Young star Marcus Bontempelli sealing the win.
He's hit it pretty nice.
He has a really good player in that squad.
The Bulldogs kept pace with the top sides by dismantling Melbourne by 32 points at the MCG. Liberatore was dogged in his approach, equaling the VFL AFL tackles record with 19.
19 tackles.
He's been tackling all afternoon.
That's a lot.
He's kicking goals.
Next stop for the Bulldogs was Sydney, the Greater Western Sydney Giants' home ground of Spotless Stadium. The Dogs tried a few different things to stop the Giants' momentum, but nothing seemed to work. They returned home with a 25-point loss.
That's a big loss, to be fair.
To dodging a bullet.
Giants are pretty good, though.
To scrap and scramble, but the defender, the
you see that little shimmy there? That was
it's
nice.
Long, it's good, it's pure, and the Dogs will want that.
But overcame an injury-hit Magpies for a 21-point win. Against the West Coast Eagles in round 11, the Dogs survived a late comeback to win by just 8 points.
11 games down for the Dogs, 8 wins, and they are absolutely for real.
In front of 40,000 fans at Adelaide Oval, the Bulldogs took on Port Adelaide and held off the Power in a thriller.
Seconds keep rolling. 4, 3, 2.
They held on. It's always good when it's close and it holds on to the end.
One of the best.
I love tight endings.
I imagine it was a pretty good spectacle to watch. It was definitely on the edge of the seat stuff from a coaching point of view, but yeah, for our players were enormous today.
Before the calm of a round 14 bye came the chaos of a round 13 caning at the hands of the Cats. Geelong was clinical.
Geelong pretty good though, to be fair.
Winning by 57 points.
They beat them this week as well.
Returning
yeah.
to take on Sydney in round 15, the Bulldogs needed to bounce back and did. Jason Johannesson booted a goal in the dying seconds to give his side a thrilling 4-point win.
He's living the dream!
Coach Lou Beveridge said this game was worth about 10 wins.
Really?
Back home at Etihad Stadium, the Bulldogs
beat the
Tigers and survived an almighty scare from Richmond to escape by just 10 points.
Almighty scare from Richmond. like this season as well. Richmond always scare teams, then lose at the end. It's quite frustrating to watch.
With a comfortable 48-point win over an injury-depleted Gold Coast, but the round 17 win looked to have come at a significant cost, with Jake Stringer suffering a suspected shoulder injury. The injury ravaged.
I was thought it was playing.
Took another big hit in round 18 with a 15-point loss to St Kilda. More pain with a season-ending injury to Mitch Wallace with a badly broken leg. And
so many injuries.
Jack Redler ruptured his ACL.
They're really hurting and feeling it. Obviously, a little bit disappointed about the loss, but they're really feeling it for Mitch and his family, and also for Red and his family.
The wounded Bulldogs journeyed to Simmons Stadium to face fellow top four aspirant Geelong, keen to reverse the 57-point hammering from 5 weeks earlier. That didn't happen, losing by 25 points this time. In round 20, the Bulldogs struck a psychological blow ahead of September, defeating North Melbourne by 14 points in a spiteful clash at Etihad Stadium.
Oh boy.
The Bulldogs then survived the scare to go a step closer to confirming their place in the top six on the ladder with a thrilling 3-point win over Collingwood.
Dogs are going to win!
That is a big win, to be fair.
And the Dogs bid to secure a home elimination final remained on track after they rocked to a comfortable 40-point win over Essendon.
Nice.
Like it had in many victories previously, the win would come at a high cost. Acting captain Easton Wood forced from the ground late in the third term. The Dogs did not finish the season on a good note, losing to Fremantle, which sent Matthew Pavlich into retirement in style with a gritty 20-point upset. It was a dog of a day. Nothing went right, and they were consigned to a 7th-place finish and an elimination final against West Coast.
All right.
The first game of the finals after a refreshing new bye week, the Dogs produced one of the greatest finals wins in the club's history, stunning West Coast by 47 points to march
47.
Into
the final. That's massive.
And like most football fans, the coach was stunned.
I don't think it'd be that much of a battery. Yeah.
If the Dogs were to go any deeper into the finals, they would have to overcome three-time defending premiers Hawthorn in the semis. And in front of more than 87,000 fans at the MCG, that's exactly what they did.
55 years to the night.
That was a great win for them. I think that's why I said this as well.
The golden brown era over as the Dogs ended Hawthorn's triple premiership reign and advanced to their first preliminary final since 2010. In a stunning performance that continued the Bulldogs' fairy tale September, they outmuscled and outran their more experienced opponents to win by 23 points.
Look at that teamwork, though. Look at that teamwork. That's some brilliant teamwork.
It made for just the second time since 1998 that a team has won through to a prelim final from 7th spot on the ladder. Afterwards, a gracious losing coach, Alistair Clarkson, gave his opposite a hug, wished him well. The Bulldogs, with many excited supporters in tow, travelled to Spotless Stadium in Sydney to face the Giants in an historic preliminary final at the venue. It was a final for the ages.
Nice.
Tory Dixon had a set shot at goal after the siren, hitting the post for the most glorious behind in Bulldogs history.
The siren will sound. A 55-year drought. The Dogs are in the grand final.
A sensational 6-point win and their first grand final in more than half a century. The Bulldogs, who had lost 9 of their 10 previous grand final qualifiers, were now within one win of the first premiership since 1954. Standing in their way, the Sydney Swans in the biggest show of all.
That was a brilliant video. It was a decent story, and they started off really rough. Like, not just starting off, just like in terms of injuries, they got quite a lot of injuries. So yeah, that's unfortunate for those players, but in the end it was all worth it. So there's two more videos left. First of all, AFL Big Bumps. This should be fun. Nice little intro there. Very well put together.
Welcome back. My only visit to the tribunal as an offender cost me the league best and fairest. I was 14 and had pimples and found guilty of wrestling. It taught me a lesson that would last forever.
For a few minutes,
focus on these clashes. The majority got off scot-free. Today, our precious umpires would be poring over every single bump, looking for an excuse to send the poor blighters before the tribunal. These are the big bumps.
What did he say earlier? He said something so weird. Anyway. Ooh. some colourful pits earlier. Oh boy. Oh boy. That is a knockout. An absolute knockout. Oh. Oh. Come on. Massive. Madness. Absolute madness.
And this young fella's played a great game. He got the heavy one that time. Heard is the favourite. Runs straight into the one position. A good hip and shoulder there by his side. But he's got the free kick.
Double whammy there.
Eagles going to the line. Kick us up towards full forward. There's Van der
Haag. Oh. He goes down there in the he's out. He's knocked out cold there. Ooh. Oh boy. Oh boy. The way it landed as well, that's double. If the hit didn't knock him out, the ground would have. Ooh. Unbelievable. Oh, knocked him over there. Oh boy, that is the roughest one so far. That is the biggest one so far. Oh, imagine running into that though, because you just don't know it's coming. You're running forward for momentum, and suddenly you hit someone else. What happens in a second? And you just don't see it coming. Yeah, exactly. That's a perfect example. You just don't see it coming. Oh boy! See, even when you're running into it, you still don't see it coming. It just happens. Oh boy! Oh! He might be hurt. He might be hurt. Yeah, commentator. Yeah. Nice one. He might be hurt. Not like he got knocked out or anything, but he might be hurt. So that's a big bomb. Ooh. Oh! Double. I'm assuming they're all okay right now. Well, this is a long time ago, but I'm assuming they're all okay. Took him down below there. Oh boy. Oh boy. This is mental. This is absolutely mental. Jeez. Jeez! Absolute madness! Absolute madness! Ho 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 ho, whoa, whoa! Whoa! It's an aggressive hug, basically. As the commentator might say, he might be hurt. Oh my! You got smashed in the face, then landed head first on the floor. That's like, that's the worst head injury in the sport, anyway. Ooh. I wonder if any of these happened, like, on the line. Like, someone's about to score a goal, then next second, smash! I bet that's happened once, at least, It might have. I don't know. Maybe it's never happened. But that'd be crazy, wouldn't it? The guy's about to score. Bang. It's a rough one. The way he jumped as well. Having a bad day. There's a lot of big bumps there, obviously, since it's a big bumps video, but that was brilliant. That was brilliant. Well put together. Wow. Absolutely crazy how rough the sport can be, but that's just part of the sport. And yeah. Some of those are like proper bad, proper massive knockouts though. So I guess he more of his goals then, yeah. That's nice. Because in the last video I watched of him, they didn't show too much of the goals. They showed a few goals here and there, but they didn't show too much. So it's nice to see actual play from him. It's nice. Brent Harvey. Good player. Nice goal. It's good at his little runs, isn't he? Nice. Obviously, I didn't see that, but it's from the tight angle. It's a nice finish. He's good at these runs. He left two on the floor there. He's really good at these runs. Nice. I love that old scoreline, by the way, in the corner. That little like hanging off the corner. That's pretty cool. Nice. This is a lot more recent, I can see. Oh, left him on the floor. Nice goal. He's good at these runs. He's really good at those runs. He can get away from players easy. Nice mark. I think that's the first mark of this video. That's a brilliant mark. Brilliant mark. Oh. He knows exactly where to run, how to run, and when to shoot. Brilliant. Absolutely brilliant. Oh. Oh, yes. Oh, yes. What a goal. I love this. It's really nice to see a lot more of his goals. Nice. The other guy got no chance there against him. He knows how to beat players. Leave him on the floor so easily. Oh boy. Some brilliant goals in this video. Absolutely brilliant goals. There he goes. What a player. That was an absolutely brilliant 4-7 video. I really enjoyed that. Really enjoyed that. So yeah, this is probably like, I think this was the best video out of the three that I recorded today. The Western Bulldogs video was very good as well. Big Bumps was really funny. But this is a really nice compilation. Some really good goals. Very enjoyable. Anyway, let me know which round 10 games you want and I'll react to them from round 11 onwards. I'll react to every single game. This is your boy Davidoff. Please like, share, subscribe. Thanks for watching. Have a good day and see ya. Life is good right now. Take your mind out the gutter. Look around. The sun's shining. The sky's so blue. Things grow.